after I've broken out of the clothes guard. Could just be that he got two sleeves inside the play spider guard. As soon as I can, I'm going to be walking, pulling him up to a six. And here. If I have a little bit of a lower posture, it may not make as much sense for me to try to bring my leg up, or I may just prefer stack passing. I can lower and kind of shoot in to get my knees under the hips. And now I make this, can't really see my butterfly grip, my wrist-to-wrist grip here. It's going to be a really tight grip to help pull his hips up as high onto my lap as I can, okay? Now I'm going to feed the collar to make a nice thumb-in grip as my right hand goes to the belt, and I reinforce this grip with my knee. Now, I get to apply some pressure and make Rob uncomfortable. I'm going to go to a full plank, trying to touch his nose to his knee, or his knee to his nose, and I just open my chest to let the leg go by. Rob will tell you it's pretty uncomfortable to be forced into full flexion like that. See how I was able to kind of lift him with the initial grip? Now I have a really strong position here. My wrist-to-wrist grip. The hips are already on his hips are already on top of my hips. If I need to adjust, I'll just pull them up a bit higher. Now I can start to go with my thumb in grip and my belt grip. I apply pressure. If I don't like the guy or if I'm mad at him, I could keep him here for a minute. It's very uncomfortable. And then I can let the leg go by opening my chest. What I don't want to see is us like trying to throw the legs by. It gives too much space for them to high leg recover. So take your time. Stack them fully. Be in a full plank. I'm planked on Rob. And then as I open, so I go from this posture to this posture, it gives just enough space for the leg to go by. And for me to connect my chest to his chest. Okay? That's how I'll solidify that position. Does that make sense, everybody? Give her a shot. On two.